there a house there?
Oh!
Damn it.
All right.
I didn't want to pass right through there. Of course, we got an enemy. Huge spider. Huge spider and huge spider. Who's free? Again and Branwyn.
As well as I can.
Some of us are getting free.
Why me?
Butt kicking for goodness!
Imuin still held. Where is she? Right there. Here we go.
Sure.
We could search for these traps, but it would take forever, so it's much easier in a dungeon. This Brendan and LaSala, Red Wizards of Thay, I suppose. There's another one. Oh, Diana. We can't step on this thing. Danak, also, over here. It is so sad to have met you this fine day. Normally we'd be quite ecstatic to have visitors, but in these troubled times we really do desire privacy. We just can't afford to have anyone knowing that we're here. That is why you must die. four wizards. You probably will die. Just wait a moment. We won't bother you. Just let us go on our way, and you'll never see us again. Sorry, but the Red Wizards of Thay are not known for their magnanimous nature. We're going to have to kill you. Diner here says, beware, Sapphire. If those are indeed the Red Wizards of Thay, the truth of which I have no reasons to doubt, they are as skilled in arts arcane as they are devious. This accent is all too familiar. You must be the Rashemi witch spotted in these parts by our friends. I can see that Edwin did not carry out his mission as ordered. LaSala, I suggest that we not tell him that we have done his job. The further away he is, the less obstructions he creates for us. Oh, well, we are going to die, because we can't even get to these people quickly.
Tempest, give us victory!
What can we do against these people? Fireball? Yeah, fireball, fireball. What the hell? She's like charmed or something? A fireball? We killed... We knocked him down or something. Alright, we're all running around like crazy. So is this Stinking Cloud then? Who do we have control of? Just yeah. Myself?
Yep.
Ah, resist fear on Minsk. Did it work? No? Was I interrupted? I might have been interrupted. Waiting to take a potion.
Fine.
Let's step out of this stuff. Take your potion. There you go. Hurt themselves.
Damn forest always reminds me of Pansy Elf.
Are you back? Kill these guys. Let's get out of the range of the stinking cloud, or whatever they cast. It wasn't cloud kill, otherwise we'd all be dead.
Tis a fine day to die.
One of us is missing.
Alright, alright!
Butt kicking for goodness!
If Tempus wills it.
Head count.
Hey, how
what
are things is going?
It? Such menial tasks.
As directed.
She was all the way over there. Good thing we already cleared that area out. Wow. Alright, good. We survived. That's awesome. It's more than what I thought was going to happen. I think they hurt themselves, these people. Denak cast mirror image. Brandon cast mirror image. Diana cast ghost armor. Denak cast a horror. And then Diana cast stinking cloud, which hurt all of them. Nice. Well done, Diana. Did as much damage to them as it did to us. Probably even more so, because the ones that were feared ran out of the effect of the stinking cloud. And me, I did eventually. Alright, so we've got some magical robes. Very happy to see that. A scroll of grease. Protection from petrification. Burning hands. Armor. Blindness.
They wish my ear.
Aganazar's Scorcher is another magical robe. Magical ring. Some potions of healing. A scroll of remove magic. And some darts for Minsk.
As well as I can.
Am I full? Okay, you can give me some. Okay, so I know. Don't everybody have burning hands? Shocking grasp I have. I don't think I have it. Alright. Alright, done. Armor. Protection scroll. Protection from petrification, which I believe I already have. Yeah, that's it. We both have it, okay. Grease, which I'm pretty sure we both have. There's grease. And grease, okay. What's this? Minsk. Blindness is level 1. Ganazar's Scorcher is level 2. Remove magic is level 3. This is the combat version of dispel magic. It will only affect opponents. A remove magic dispels the magical effects upon any enemies within the area. This includes effects given from spells, potions, and certain magical items such as wands. It does not, however, affect enchanted magical items. The chance of the spell succeeding is determined by the level of the caster and the level of the magic being dispelled. The base chance of successfully dispelling is 50%. For every level that the caster of remove magic is above the original caster, her chance of success increases by 5%. For every level that the caster of remove magic is below the original caster, her chance of success decreases by 10%. However, despite the difference in levels, there is always at least a 1% chance of success or failure. Thus, if a caster is 10 levels higher than the magic she is trying to dispel, there is only a 1% chance of failure. Similarly, if the caster is 4 levels lower than the magic she is trying to dispel, there is only a 10% chance of success. Intuitively, this spell is almost useless if the target is 5 or more levels higher than the caster. Note, while this spell dispels the individual effects of grease, web, stinking cloud, and other such spells, it does not dispel the area of effect. Got it, alright. Let me try to write this thing. Good. Okay, so blindness, Agonosaurus, Scorcher. I think I have that. That's blindness. So blindness is illusion phantasm. Okay. Yeah, Dinah here doesn't know it. And this is level 2. Wah. Homie, don't play that. Okay, good.
It is a fine day to die.
All right.
So these are just plain old quarter staffs. Quarter staves, rather. Well, can't say I like these red wizards of Thay very much. This particular bunch was not too bright. Bugs me how I can't uncover that. Alright. Anything lurking in this tiny area? Well, I guess that's why they would call it the Red Wizard Forest. Oh, who's this? Farrington?
What you want?
A Tazloy has stolen my Scroll of Wisdom, Wanderer, and fled eastward towards the Ettercap's lair. The poor Tazloy is probably quite dead by now, but the Ettercaps, of course, will not recognize the scroll's value. If you could retrieve it for me, I promise to brighten your karma. Brighten my karma? Farrington, a strange priest in the Wood of Sharp Teeth, has had his Scroll of Wisdom stolen. He appears to know the area well, and suspects that it has fallen into the claws of an Ettercap to the east. Well, that's cool, because I did not know that there was an Ettercap lair. Oh, we found it already, apparently. Ah, my scroll. Take it with you, Wanderer. It will increase your karmic essence. Farrington gave me the very scroll he asked me to retrieve. Okay. So you already found it. Is it this thing? Alright, we're done with the Red Wizard Forest in any case.
Who wants a full plate and packing steel?
Has your aura grown in wisdom lately? Not sure.
Sure.
How was that? Oh, our spell's wearing off? Good timing. Okay, off to the Friendly Arm Inn.
Sure.
Gotta rest and memorize some identify spells. No?
I must rest. Another bad case of hunger, Chief.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Why me?
Okay, so we've got... I wonder if I could just pass this stuff around, though. It's a mage robe of cold resistance. Cold resistance plus 20%. These are a common sight in the Sword Coast region, especially as one travels north towards Neverwinter and Icewind Dale. Many young mages receive it as a gift from their instructors upon successfully completing their first 5 years of study. As with other such robes, they can only be worn by those of the wizardly profession, of course. Cold resistance plus 20. That's electrical resistance. While seen with less frequency than some other mage robes, those of electrical resistance can hardly be considered a rarity. Some are worn by paranoiacs seeking protection from a ragged mountain storm, but many more are worn by mages seeking to protect themselves from the intrigues of others of their kind. Wizardly profession, yes, plus 20%. Ring that identified. So I got cold resistance. That's fire resistance. I got knave's robe. Got more here. Pass these. See if I can find out what these are. Fire resistance and cold resistance. I don't know, we're gonna carry so many things around for different seasons. I don't know. So we still have to, I guess we'll sell these then. So we still have to identify the scroll and the ring. Oh, we got some ready already. But I've used them. Alright, so we just need a rest.
Such menial tasks.
I'll get those.
Someone else.
I'll get those back.
Alright.
Now someone talk to the guy. Yeah, I'll sell them both. What? When your party is scattered. Is there somebody outside? We're all in the same tavern.
Yes?
Who's Wade?
Camaraderie.
Hey!
And steel on steel. The stuff of legend, right, Boo?
Beep. By the gods of health and hearth, it's good to see the friendly arm again. Can anyone here imagine a better sight than these hallowed halls looming before you when you've had bandits at your backside all the way from Baldur's Gate? You sound most relieved to have made it here. How treacherous was your passage? Eh? How treacherous? Treacherous enough that I must forego my usual blustering tale of the journey and push past you, friend, lest I die of thirst before I reach the bar. Beware the north if you be allergic to bandits. Bentley, a bottle of your second cheapest wine. I'm not allergic to them, but I will kill them.
All right.
Now we can rest. Alright, so what is this scroll? Cursed Scroll of Foolishness. The scroll is cursed. It would be unwise to read it, as the effects could prove fatal. Really? And the ring? Ring of Energy, the victor. So that was the scroll that he wanted us to find? I wonder if he knew what scroll it was. He just did him a favor and he was giving us a fatal scroll. Ring of Energy, the Victor. Crafted by Drow Mages of the Underdark, this weapon was used in an arranged battle between two rival houses. It's a weapon? I guess so. Each combatant was allowed to use a single magic item to aid his efforts. This ring was the weapon used by the victor of the contest, though he never laid hands on it. It was worn by his sibling and fired from the crowd, striking his opponent squarely in the back. Everyone witnessing agreed it was a brilliant interpretation of the rules. Charge abilities. 2d6, no save. Okay. So you throw it. Okay. That's interesting. I want to see something.
Yes?
Just mince because it's less likely to kill him. Oh, inadequate intelligence, really? How much intelligence does he have? 15. Oh, wow. He's pretty intelligent. But, yeah. Oh, poor Minsk. His intelligence is only 8. So if he takes this... Cast it on somebody? You have been cursed with foolishness. His intelligence is 10 and his wisdom is 3. Haha. Alright. So I wonder if we can sell this thing.
Alright.
It doesn't look like we could sell it. We can't sell this backbiter thing. It's a cursed spear. Actually, I'm just going to drop it on the floor. Well, we have Dinah here, this ring. Oh, we can wear it as a ring, right. Forgot about that. So I already have a... Yeah, this is a ring of wizardry. And the ring of the princes, AC and saving throw plus one. That seems like a good ring for her to have. I'm done.
Please seek yourself whatever you wish. Yes.
Sure.
So I think next. We are supposed to go to the Cloakwood. But I think next we'll go to this fishing village just to see what's there. Eventually, I will go to this lighthouse. Eventually. I should go to Oldcaster soon, too. But yeah, I've been doing pretty well in our adventures lately. Having some trouble, but not insurmountable. I'm surprised we defeated the Wizards of Thay on our first try. I was sure they were going to kill us. But it was their own ineptitude that did them in. Casting a stinking cloud, I'm pretty sure it was. Cloud kill would have been much more devastating. We have stinking cloud on themselves and us. And then casting horror on some of us, so we ran out of the cloud. They suffered the effects, and it went unconscious and basically just suffered. That was interesting, though. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.